We're back with our reporters and our analysts. You know, Sondland, I'm going to play a couple of clips. This is the vice president speaking at a European National Security International Affairs conference of Vice President Mike Pence in Europe. Some awkward, very awkward moments.
I bring greetings from the 45th president of the United States of America, President Donald Trump.
The time has come for our European partners to stand with us and the Iranian people, to stand with our allies and friends in the region. The time has come for our European partners to withdraw from the Iran nuclear deal and join with us as we bring the economic and diplomatic pressure necessary to give the Iranian people, the region, and the world the peace, security, and freedom they deserve.
Some painful silence there when he speaking about the president of the United States and speaking about Iran. He didn't get beyond the awkward silence. It does underscore some major differences right now between the Trump administration and the European allies.
It certainly does. Definitely awkward moment, but definitely speaks to this moment for specifically President Trump, how he's not very well liked right now, and certainly speaks to the deterioration of the relationship specifically between President Trump and our European allies. All of that moment where Vice President Pence kind of gave the president a shout out there and said he brings his thanks from the president, that kind of pause in the room, that was deafening silence. And it should be noted that Senator Graham, a Republican in the room, just he mentioned him and he did get applause there. So this speaks to specifically how much President Trump has let that relationship go downhill. We've heard a little bit from Angela Merkel there this week. I also want to say it kind of speaks to the White House not reading the room. Certainly the tone at the conference this weekend was difficult. That was described by many people there. That really the undercurrent of all this. So the White House leaving an applause line in his written transcript. Yeah. The fact that Pence broke to hear applause and didn't hear, and he was kind of a little ruffled by it, you know, speaks that they're not reading the relationship fundamentally.
My gosh, the whole watching that, listening to it, it just reminded me, I saw it with apologies to Jeb Bush, but of the Jeb Bush please clap moment where it's like, and this is the part where you guys applaud for me, yeah. You know? The thing about Pence, everything Sondland says is exactly right about them reading the room. The thing about Pence is, Pence's entire political now and political future is tied to Donald Trump. So Mike Pence doesn't care, really, beyond the awkwardness, if they applaud him. Because you know who liked all that? Donald Trump. And that's his only path.
But
Mike
Donald
Pence's
Trump,
only path.
President Trump likes to get applause when he makes those kinds of statements. Pence was waiting for the applause. He got silence.
Well, I mean, why? Why is this a surprise? 16 years after we go into Iraq, let's replace some names here. We'd like you to stand with us on a WMD issue related to a big I country in the Middle East. And we have to sit there and say, after we brought the Europeans into Iraq, they might say, well, asking us to stand behind you on Iran on WMD, maybe not so much. And by the way, you should say thanks for us being in Iraq, because we lost a lot of our people. So I think if you spent 10 seconds reading the speech, you'd say they're going to be reminded of Iraq, and nobody's going to say this is a good idea.